In this short learning video, a selected extract of our course Introduction to Transport Modes will briefly present the main types of cargo, describe the most typical transport flows, speak about the parties, before listing the most common transport modes. Let us start with the types of cargo. The term cargo designates a transported material, and the latter can be split in three high-level categories. First, we find a bulk cargo, cargo which is transported unpacked and in large quantities. It can be liquid, for example, crude oil, vegetable oil, wine, fruit juice, liquefied gas, and so on. Or it can be dry, like for example, with coal, grain, iron ore, gravel, corn, flour, or other. Then, we find a cargo which is transported break bulk, meaning it is loaded as separate pieces without the usage of a container. It could be items like drums of oil, rolls of steel or rolls of paper, cargo on pallets or in crates, or single items with or without protective packaging. And finally, we find a containerized cargo, which is a cargo loaded or stuffed into a container, which is then handled and transported as a single item. And this, possibly over multiple legs, meaning multiple flights or sailings, or mode, meaning for example, first by road, then by ocean, without the cargo being unloaded from this container. More or less any kind of cargo can be loaded into containers. This cargo can be on pallets or in boxes, or loaded directly into the container. It can be finished products like clothes, computer toys, machine parts, or rougher cargo like steel bars or similar. Bulk cargo, like for example oil, can also be loaded into specialized containers like a tank container and then moved as normal containers are. These two categories, break bulk cargo and containerized cargo, are the ones you will most likely be working with, and in this e-learning we'll focus mainly on these two and the modes related to them. When cargo is produced and ready, it needs to be moved. To do so, various transportation modes are available. A transportation mode being a mean of transport, like for example truck, air, or ocean. You will select one of them in function of your cargo type, size, quantity, value, origin and destination, as well as your timeline for delivery. A transport can be as simple as a truck transport from A to B, a one-leg or step and one-mode transport. Cargoes are loaded on the truck in A, delivered to B, and offloaded. Or it can be more complex, like shown here, requiring different transport legs or steps and calling upon various modes, with the most complex or costly modes being considered the main mode for this transport. In our example here, the main mode is ocean, as it is considered more complex than truck, and also it will most likely represent a higher part of the cost than the truck transport part. The part of the transport covered by this main mode is also referred to as the main carriage, with the phase before it called the pre-carriage, and the one after it called the on-carriage. In our example, the cargo is pre-carried by truck from the supplier to a port, where it is loaded for the main carriage on a vessel, shipped to a port of import, offloaded and on-carried once more by truck to its final destination. There are many parties involved in the transportation of cargo, and on this slide we'll review some of the main ones. First, we find a principal. It is the party who contracts the forwarder or the carrier for the transport. It is the party who requests and generally pays for the transport. Then, we find a shipper, also called consignor, and this is the party who provides the goods and hands them over to the carrier for transport. It is generally the place from where the goods are shipped. The receiver, or consignee, is the party to whom the freight is shipped, the party which will receive it, and generally the destination location. The forwarder is a logistics service provider who can handle the full organization of a transport, typically including additional services such as custom clearance and combining various modes, for example truck and ocean. He then subcontracts the different parts of the transport to one or more carriers, for example a road carrier, a shipping line, an airline, or uses his own equipment to move the goods and acts as a carrier. And finally, we find a carrier or carriers who are responsible for the carriage itself. They provide the unit of transport and handle the physical move of the goods. In our example, a principal uses a forwarder to book a transport from the shipper in China to the receiver or consignee in the United States. The forwarder decides to subcontract the pre-carriage in China to a local ground carrier, then uses an international shipping line for the main transport, and in the US uses a rail provider for part of the on-carriage, and finishes with his own truck. The three most common and important transport modes you will most likely work with are truck transport, ocean transport, and air transport. Depending on the cargo, area, and customer you work with, you may also work with two less common ones, which we'll cover in this module, rail transport and barge transport. Put together, truck and rail transport are often referred to as surface or ground transport. And if barge is also included, they are grouped under the term inland transport. A transport using more than one mode can be called a combined, multimodal, or intermodal transport. We'll stop here for our short extract, but you can find a full description of all modes and many more details in our online course. Link in description. You can get it at a discount using the U10 coupon or by subscribing to our newsletter. We hope you found this extract useful, and please subscribe to our channel.